Most of you have heard in the news that there were 3 commercial airplanes that recently crashed over a 7-day period of time. These planes crashing in this period of time is yet another parallel to the Most High's touching the dead statute that he has woven into his end time timeline and into his judgment against the scattered descendants of Israel. He is in control of everything that happens on the earth and in the cosmos that surround it, and the inhabitants of the world are about to find this out. I will share with you some of the details that are woven into these flights that parallel what the Most High has led me to speak in some recent videos, and how these details tie in with the last one-third of his 42 restored 30-day months. I will also share with you how 3 branches of the law driving into Hikwe's camp yesterday and giving his servant and his family 7 days to move ties in with the last one-third of this period of time as well. AH-5017 was the 3rd of these commercial planes that crashed in these 7 days. During these 7 days, the Most High led me to speak about the parallels of the 3rd day and the 7th day that he wove into the 10 dates that his word gives to us for the account of the flood. He sent the flood waters upon the inhabitants of the world 4,118 years ago. 4,000 of these years represent the first two-thirds of the 6,000 years of this era of time that the Most High is cutting short per the testimony of his word that he spoke to us through his only begotten Son. Counting today, there remains just 7 days in the first two-thirds of his 42 restored 30-day months. I read where the number of people that were killed on flight AH-5017 was raised from 116 people to 118. According to GMT time, where Hikwe has pitched his camp at this time, and GMT time where it crashed at the same time that I was uploading the last video. Hikwe's camp is pitched 8 hours behind the time zone that this crash occurred. The last video was called Because of a Month. This video discussed the Most High sending his wrath upon the descendants of Israel because you refused to stand with his anointed and return to him through that which he has restored. That which he has restored includes his restored timing of his Sabbaths and the rest of his appointed times that are in his restored 30-day months. The article that I read, the articles that I read said that this plane crashed 30 miles or 50 kilometers north of the Burkina Faso border. Air Navigation Services said that they lost contact with it 50 minutes after takeoff. In the 10 dates of the flood video that I uploaded on the 3rd of these 7 days, I spoke that the 25th day of the 11th month, according to our Creator's restored 30-day months, is 50 days prior to the first day of his Feast of That Which is Unleavened, and that it is 51 days prior to the wave sheaf offering. The 25th day of the 11th month is the anniversary of the day that Noah let loose the third dove. There are volumes of parallels of 50 and 51 that the Most High has woven into his end time timeline and into his witness against the scattered descendants of Israel. In this video, I also spoke about how the Most High restored his 30-day months through 3 30-day periods on one side of the scattering of the last third of my hair per his Ezekiel chapter 5 prophecy, and 3 30-day periods on the other side of the scattering. The last third of the my hair was a parallel to the last third of these 42 30-day months. The flight number for this Algerian flight was AH-5017. 17 is one-third of 51. AH is a representative of the Almighty's hand. The flight number of the first of these 3 planes to crash was flight number MH-70. MH-17, I'm sorry. This is the Most High doubling this third part of 51. Ahaziah sent 3 groups of 50 and 1 to bring Hikwe's servant Elijah to him. Elijah returned with the third group of 50 and 1. He returned with them to tell Ahaziah face to face that he was going to die. Since Hikwe sent me to you in similitudes of the prophecies concerning his servant Elijah, there is going to come a point in time that he brings me before the world's face on a physical plane to tell you that 96.66% of you are going to die. We are fast approaching the beginning of the last one-third of his restored 42 restored 30-day months. Yeshua gave a parable for this final third of time. He said in Matthew chapter 24, verse 8, all of these things, referring to wars and rumors of wars and kingdoms rising upon kingdoms and famines and earthquakes and such against places, are the beginning of birth pains. There certainly have been many wars and rumors of wars and kingdoms rising upon their own kingdoms and famines and earthquakes and such against places around the world during the first two-thirds of these 42 months. Yeshua chose to use the word that is associated with birth pains for a reason. The greatest of the birth pains will be at the great and at the great and the fearful day of Yahweh's wrath, at the time that the birth of the millennium, where Satan and his crew will be bound for 1,000 years. However, there is more that is woven into this parable. Yeshua said that these things are the beginning of the birth pains. Most of a child's growth is seen during the final one-third that he or she is in the womb. In the video that I uploaded at the same time that AH-5017 was crashing, I spoke about how the Most High uncovered my arm in a magnificent way 116 days after the 40 days of his Ezekiel chapter 4 prophecy ended. He did so by uncovering his 42 30-day months on the anniversary of the day that he opened the ark's door for his servant Noah. On the day of this crash, all of the news articles that I saw that covered this crash said that there were 116 people on board. It was not until the next day that it was reported that there were 118. How could they make this mistake? Didn't they know how many people were on board? In this video, I also spoke about the two goodly vessels of fine brass that were as precious as gold that were offered up to the Most High. In lieu of the death toll rising from 116 to 118 people, what are the odds that Yahweh's end-time messenger of his covenant uploads a video at the same time that this plane is crashing that I spoke about him uncovering my arm 116 days after the 40 days of his Ezekiel chapter 4 prophecy ended, and that I also spoke about his two goodly vessels of fine brass that were more precious than gold that were offered up to him? And in the figuring of these odds, put into the equation what he has woven into this with how he uncovered my arm and when he did so. The odds of these things are impossible. Like I said, he did so by uncovering his 42 30-day months on the anniversary of the day that he opened the ark's door for his servant Noah on his restored calendar. The two goodly vessels represent the feet of his two witnesses that lie dead on the streets of Jerusalem for 3.5 days, which is 84 hours. Yahweh has woven several tiers of 84 days into the testimony of his word and into his end-time timeline to substitute the 84 hours of the death of his second witness. On the day that of AH-5017's crash, there were two people who were in a tent in Virginia who were killed by a storm. Yahweh's end-time servant is dwelling in a tent per his Hosea chapter 12 prophecy. This prophecy tells us, I, Elohim, brought you out of the land of Egypt. Yet again I will make you to dwell in tents in the day of my appointed time, referring to the time of the second Exodus. I have spoken through my prophets, and I will multiply my revelations through similitudes through the hand of my prophets, referring to at the time of his appointed time for the second Exodus. There were also two American soldiers that were killed in Afghanistan on the day of this plane crash. The flight number of the plane that crashed in Taiwan during these 7 days was 222. 222 is 220 plus 2. Yahweh opened the ark's door 220 days after he told us that he remembered his servant Noah. All of these parallels to two in these 7 days are symbolic of the death of his two witnesses. And through the testimony of his word, he has substituted the death of his second witness with different tiers of 84 days. When the three branches of man's law came to serve Yahweh's anointed with their 7-day notice, they told me that on the 7th day they would return to give me a citation, and they told me that they will be bringing a tow truck for the vehicle that the Most High has provided me with, and that they will seize all of the storehouse that the Most High has given to his servant and to his servant's family. My father is not leading me to hearken to their evacuation order. He led me to tell them that this is his land. It is his word that commands you and I to flee to the mountains. I am obeying his word. Man's law does not trump Yahweh's law. Not only that, the United States Congress passed a law during the President Reagan's reign that says that the Bible is the word of Elohim. This book contains the command for us to flee when the abomination of desolation has been revealed. This book testifies to who is the abomination that desolated his set apart people and desolated his word that he gave to us to set us apart to become his eternal seed. And it is this book that testifies that I am his second anointed son. Here is a detail that accompanies the seventh day when man's law will return to rise up against Yahweh's anointed. There are 84 days that encompass the day that he uncovered his 42 restored 30-day months, and this seventh day, Yahweh uncovered his 42 restored 30-day months at the end of the 27th day of the second month on his restored calendar, on the anniversary of the day that he opened the ark's door for his servant Noah. The 27th day of the second month was on May 9th on Satan's calendar. Man's law said that they will return to Yahweh's camp on July 31st. The next day, on August 1st, which is the 21st day of the fifth month on Yahweh's restored calendar, begins the final one-third of his 42 restored 30-day months. This means that if they do come here on July 31st, we will still be in this 84-day period of time that represents my death. If this is the case, since this period of time reflects the time of my death, it might be that he will allow them to take that which he has provided for my family and I, or it might be that he will put circumstances in their path that will cause them to delay coming to his camp until the next day. In any case, if this is the last 84-day tier that reflects the 84 hours of my death, great fear will fall upon them once these 84 days are ended. There is another waypoint that is associated with the 21st day of the fifth month that is woven into this as well. It is 4 months or 120 days from the second anniversary of the beginning of these 42 months on the last day of his feast of that which was unleavened a couple years ago. Yahweh's servant Moses lived for 120 years, and it is through his servant Moses that he gave us his law. Since there are 360 days in a year on his restored calendar, this is 840 days into these 42 months. Here is another 116 parallel that Yahweh has woven into the day of the AH-5017 crash. He has pitched his camp at this time in the mountains of Arizona. The day of this crash was the 24th day of July, the way that Satan taught his children to figure the months and the days. In the plains of Arizona, Phoenix recorded a record high temperature for the day of 116 degrees. Concerning the mountains becoming a plain, Yahweh's word tells us in Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6, "Then the angel answered and spoke to me, saying, This is Yahweh's word that is upon Zerubbabel, saying, Not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says Yahweh of hosts. Who are you, great mountain? Before Zerubbabel's face you will become a plain, and he will bring forth the headstone, shouting favor for favor to him." The testimony of Yahweh's word testifies that this Zerubbabel is his end-time witness that would flow out from the captivity of Mystery Babylon at the time of the end. One of the articles that I read said that the wreckage of this plane was a nearly unrecognizable tangle of blackened metal and other debris that was strewn about a 550-yard area of barren Malayan terrain. On July 13th, on Satan's calendar, I uploaded a video called A River of Blood. In this video, I spoke about the two tiers of 550 days that the Most High has woven into his end-time timeline. 550 days is five 110-day periods of time. It was 110 days from when Yahweh shut off the flood waters from raining upon the earth until he told us that he remembered his servant Noah. 4 days after this video, the Malaysian flight MH17 was shot down in Ukraine. In this video, Yahweh expanded on the number 4. He led me to speak about how the day before, on the anniversary that his servant Aaron died, we were 440 days, or four 110-day periods of time from the great and the fearful day of his wrath. The first day of the fifth month when his servant Aaron died is the fourth day of the 4 days that encompass Yahweh's Feast of First Fruits. And this day, there have been scores of such parallels as these that have accompanied the Most High's witness against those of you who are the scattered descendants of Israel. He has woven them into the news on a daily basis since he sent me with the testimony of his word. Yahweh sending his signs like these plane crashes far off from where he has gathered the scattered descendants of Israel at this time is about to come to an end. the pains are going to grow in this last trimester of these 42 months. These three planes crashing in 7 days are yet another parallel to the Most High's touching the dead statute, and so are the three officers coming to Kippur's camp and giving his servant 7 days notice. He has placed great significance on his magnification of this statute at the time of the end and the need for us to be sprinkled on the third day and on the seventh day with his water of separation if we have touched the dead. His word testifies that the dead before his face are those of you who are not following after the name of his only begotten son in your flesh. The name that he gave to his only begotten son is his word. This is recorded in the revelations of his only begotten son in chapter 19, verse 13. Following his only begotten son is following his word. Concerning his touching the dead statue, his word tells us in Numbers 19, he that touches the dead body of any man shall be unclean for 7 days. He shall purify himself with the water of separation on the third day and on the seventh day, and he will be clean. But if he does not purify himself on the third day and on the seventh day, he will not be clean. Whosoever touches the dead body of any man that is dead and does not purify himself defiles Kippur's tabernacle, and that life will be cut off from Israel. Pretty clear? Because the water of separation was not sprinkled upon him, and he is unclean, and his uncleanliness will remain upon him. In lieu of the Most High magnifying this statute as part of his witness against the scattered descendants of Israel at this time, I can assure you that it is not a coincidence that these three planes crashed in 7 days. Like I said, nor is it a coincidence that these three officers showed up giving Kippur's servant 7 days' notice. Nor is what he has spoken in the video that I uploaded on the third day of these 7 days, and in the video that I uploaded on the seventh day at the same time that the third of these planes was crashing, a coincidence. Nor is it a coincidence that there are 84 days that encompass the last days of this two-thirds waypoint. Like I said, Yahweh told his servant Elijah to go with the third group of 50 and one. They came to him in a little more of a humble way than the first two groups did. Yahweh's only begotten son told us that all who do not believe into the name that his father gave to him will be condemned. This is recorded in John 3:18. Those of you who believe into a different name than his father's word are about to be humbled. Like I said, the last trimester of Yahweh's 42 30-day months is at hand. It will begin on the 21st day of the fifth month on my father's restored calendar. This will be on August 1st on the calendar that Satan gave his children to use. Repent. His kingdom is at hand.